Next, characteristics of sound. And before we have seen that characteristics of sound waves. And next, characteristics of sound. Sound. So first characteristic that is pitch. Okay. So there are three main characteristics: pitch, loudness, and quality. First, we are going to see about pitch. So pitch that depends on its frequency. Okay, it depends on frequency. Frequency. What is it? I have explained. Frequency means the number of waves produced in 1 second. So if number of waves is less produced in 1 second, that is called a low pitch. If number of frequencies, number of waves produced in 1 second, if it is more, that sound is called a high pitch sound. Okay, so the definition we can see. Definition it is given in the book. Okay. Frequency, pitch that depends on frequency, and frequency we can measure in terms of hertz. Unit of pitch that is we can measure using the unit hertz. H is said. Then next characteristics that is loudness. Loudness that is depending on the amplitude of the sound. See here this graph. Here the amplitude of two graph, but both are different. Here amplitude it is less, and here amplitude is more, maximum disturbance. So if amplitude, if it is less, then that sound is considered soft sound. If amplitude is more, then that sound is considered loud sound. It depends on the amplitude of the sound waves. Amplitude means maximum disturbance of the particles with respect to mean position. By seeing this graph, we can understand the difference between the soft sound and loud sound. Soft sound means amplitude will be less, and loud sound means amplitude will be more. So we can measure in terms of decibel, that is dB. We can use this symbol to denote loudness, that is dB loudness. Next, quality or timbre. Next characteristics, quality or timbre. So quality or timbre, it is the characteristics of sound which distinguishes between sounds produced by different sources having same pitch and loudness. That means, you know, if we are playing different musical instruments, we can identify the sound of different musical instruments because they produce different forms of waves. See here, tuning fork, the form of waves that is like this, and flute, the form of waves that is different, and voice, human voice, that also different forms, and violin, another form of waves. So because of these different forms, it will give different qualities. We can identify that sound separately. The quality or timbre of a sound depends on the form of wave produced by the source. For example, when two musical instruments, say sitar or guitar, play exactly the same tune, one as loud and other as the other, then you can easily tell them apart because of the difference in the quality of their tones. The difference of these forms of waves, we can identify the sound of different instruments. So these are the characteristics of sound. First one, pitch. Second, loudness. Then third, quality or timbre. Next, we can see the audible and inaudible sound. So audible sound means sound which we can hear, and inaudible sound means sound which we cannot hear. So the sound which we can hear, the frequency that is in between 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz. So in between the sound, that such type of sound only we can hear. The frequency of the sound should be 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz, or a 20 kilohertz also we can say. That type of sound only we can hear. And inaudible means that sound may be below 20 hertz or more than 20,000 hertz. Such sound we cannot hear. So particular name also given for these sounds which is below 20 hertz. Such sounds are called infrasonic sound waves. Okay, such waves are called infrasonic waves. And above the waves which frequency above 20 kilohertz, such sounds are called ultrasonic waves, ultrasonic sound. Okay, so that is here audible and inaudible. Audible sound which we can hear, it has frequencies between 20 hertz and 20,000 hertz. That means 20 or 20,000 vibrations per second. Hertz, you know, hertz, that is the frequency. So in per second, 20 or 20,000 vibrations produced by that particles or sound source. Then audible sound, that means sound which cannot hear. It has frequencies less than 20 hertz or more than 20,000 hertz. Such sound, sound whose frequencies are more than 20,000 hertz, that is called ultrasonic sound. And below 20 hertz, such sounds are called infrasonic sound waves. So some of the animals can hear this infrasonic and ultrasonic sound waves. And elephant, that is, they are communicate with each other with sound having frequencies range 12 hertz to 22 hertz. That is sound we cannot hear. And dogs can hear sound frequencies higher than 20,000 hertz. And you know, during the if any earthquake, such natural calamities occur, then inside the earth it produce vibrations. So such vibrations may be more than 20 hertz, 20 kilohertz. So such vibrations we cannot hear, but animals such as dog, a cat, such animals can hear that vibrations. So they will be irritated and they will make a sound. And dolphin can detect a sound of frequencies as high 20,000 hertz. And bat also, it also will be produced ultrasonic sound waves. Using ultrasonic sound waves, it catch prey. That you will learn higher class. So today up to page number 144 I have completed. After reading this portion, if you have any doubt, you may ask.